do anything for her.
Love you, ay, pretty young thing. You need some loving from a real one. I wanna love you, ay, pretty young thing. Ay, you need some loving, and I'm a real one. Say a whole lot, what's up, what it do? I ain't trying to do too much, but come through. Cardi.
Child, I started this video off so wrong. Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. Long time no see, different setup, kinda sorta. So today y'all, we're gonna be doing a chit chat, get ready with me. I gotta go to work, so I decided to film myself getting ready. So we just gonna talk. I had a list of stuff I wanna talk about, but I lost it. So we're gonna get to these brows. Don't mind my brows because they need to be done. Alright? Okay. And the spoolie on this brow is broke, so I'm using one of my old ones to spoolie my brows. And I'm gonna go in with the brow is in on dark brown. And y'all might hear Scandal playing in the background. Yes, I'm rewatching it. I'm on season 3, the season that broke my heart. Oh, I got lash glue all up and through my eyes, bruh. That's exactly why I'm not wearing lashes today. Alright y'all, so y'all, it's July. We are halfway through 2018. Like y'all, it is July. Have you accomplished the goals that you set out for yourself? Have you done anything to work towards your dream this 2018? I have. Your girl got a new job. One of my dream jobs. It's lit. But for real, y'all, it's amazing how when you start praying and fasting and leaning on God's understanding and not your own understanding, and like walking in His will for your life and not your will for His. And not your will for your life. Like, it's amazing how things change and work out for you. Because, y'all, if I had a spent, don't get me wrong now. I loved my job at the daycare. I loved my job. I loved my kids. But it had become stagnant. I was there for 2.5 years. And I just felt like I wasn't progressing. I felt like I wasn't moving. And I was depressed. Like, y'all, like, dreading to go to work. Not wanting to go to work. But still going because it was a steady flow of income. Like, it was a steady flow of income, even though it wasn't that much. I was doing what I thought I needed to do to survive, doing what society said that I needed to do, which was work a steady job instead of listening to my heart and following my dreams. Not the dreams that other people set out for me, not the things that people say that I'd be good at. Yeah, I know I'd be a good teacher. I've been teaching since I was a little girl because I started teaching Sunday school and children's church at church. And I'm phenomenal with kids. But that, it was my passion at one point in my life. But now it's like I got to start living my life for Wesley and not for those people that say that they want me to be this or they need me to be that. Yeah, Being a teacher would have been fun, rewarding, steady money, benefits, income, you know. Seeing children grasp something and learn something would have been undoubtedly fun. But is it worth the headache of not following my dream? And I have this one friend. Don't get me wrong, I love all, she's my best friend. I've known her for forever. Like, we've been friends since we were in elementary school. Like, I love all my best friends, but don't get me wrong, Latrae understands my mental better than most of my other friends. She understands how I think, how I tick, how my mind works better than I do sometimes. Sorry if I'm not looking at y'all. I'm looking for my brush to conceal my doggone eyebrows. You know how your brushes be missing? She understands my mental capacity more so than some of my other friends. Sometimes even better than my family. Not even sometimes. Most of the times, even better than my family. Because she's an artist. She actually went to college and she graduated from the I get the school wrong. She graduated from an art school, y'all. I'm not gonna say the name. So she understands my need to be creative and the creative energy that I crave more so than anybody I have ever met. She understands it. And don't get me wrong, my other friends support me wholeheartedly. Like, Mimi and Antoine and CJ and Ebony and Bree, they support my dreams wholeheartedly. They're actually the first people I've done makeup on besides like family. They support me. Those are the girls that were in my photo shoot. Like, they have my whole heart because they saw something in me, or they see something in me that for the longest I didn't see in myself. And now that I work at the place that I work at, it's like, maybe this, my dream is for me. Maybe God did give me my talent for a reason. So it's all about finding yourself and letting God do his will, in his time and in his way, and not trying to rush it. Because you see your friends graduating college. Like, I saw so many of my classmates graduate college this May and December. Some will graduate in December. And it was like, well, dang, if I had went to school when I was supposed to, that could be me too. But realizing that that's not in the cards that God has for my life, I'm like, I'm okay with missing out on that. I'm still gonna go to school, but it won't be for education. It won't be for anything that I don't see myself doing. So, that's that. That's why I kind of, sort of, I took a break from YouTube because I needed to reevaluate why I wanted to be a YouTuber and why I do what I do. And is it really for a purpose, and is it really for a reason, and like spending that time with God? And like, I completely shut everybody out. I didn't let anybody know what I was going through. I didn't let anybody know that I was depressed, because, you know, being in a black family, being depressed is like, you all right? Why are you sad? Nobody really understands what being depressed is. They just think it's a wave of emotions. It is a wave of emotions, but it's more to that than just a wave of emotions. It's way more to it. And no, I was not medically diagnosed with depression. I just know how I felt, and I say I was depressed because I didn't want to do anything. I'm lazy, but when I got to the point where I was not cleaning up my room, not paint my nails, not paint my toes, like, I'm the most girly girl y'all could ever imagine. And when I stopped painting my toes, when I stopped caring about certain stuff, I knew then that something was not right with me. And I had to figure that out for me, by myself, with me. And I still haven't told my friends why I, like, literally, like, shut them out. Like, I didn't let anybody know what was going on. Nobody knew when I had the job interview for the place I work at now. Nobody knew. Well, Trey knew, but I really didn't tell anybody else. I only told my mom and my sister. Because, you know, sometimes family doesn't support you. They pretend to support you. They'll be there in your cheering corner, but they really don't want the best for you. They want to see you in the situations that they're in. Not saying that that's my family, but family. And I have some of the best supporters ever in life, but still nobody knew or understood what I was going through. So I took some time and I talked to God, and me and God had this come to Jesus meeting. And he was like, you know what my word says. You know my word says, I will give you the desires of your heart, but you must give yourself to me. And so, end of May, early June, I went on a fast. I fasted things that I loved to do, things that I loved to eat, and things that I loved to watch. And instead of doing those things, I took that time to pray and seek God and His understanding for the things I wanted out of life. No, I did not get exactly what I prayed and fasted for, but it's a start. And I believe that as I keep going through this journey of life, He'll send me what He wants me to do. And that's basically a life update. Why I haven't posted on YouTube in like 8,000 years. Well, it's only been 2 months because I posted a video right when it started warming up. It was the spring eyeshadow. It wasn't even spring, honey. It was green eyeshadow. I love the look. I hate that video because I hated my hair. What else did I want to talk about? Oh, dating while trying to find yourself, or trying to talk to someone while finding yourself. Don't do it. Find yourself. Love yourself. Be comfortable with yourself first. Until you can love yourself and look at yourself every day and say, I love myself. I love Wesley. I love da da da. I love me. I love me for who I am and who I'm supposed to be. Until you can do that, just don't. Like, don't. Because you're going to waste his time. You're going to waste your time. And you're going to be sad all over again. Yeah, you see people on social media. Yeah, you see people, let me just say this. Yeah, you see people on YouTube with these couple channels and stuff like that. But we don't know the backstory. They show us what they want us to see. And that's with anything on YouTube. Like, you show people what you want. You don't necessarily have to let people in your life. It's a choice that YouTubers make. And I respect that choice because I wouldn't want nobody all up in my business either. But that's a choice. And social media has made I don't want to say young people because I'm still young, but they have made our teenagers so susceptible. They think everything is a get rich quick scheme, or I need to do this so I can make money. I don't have to go to college so I can do this. But if we have all of these people, if we have all of these people that want to be YouTubers, who's going to be our doctors and our lawyers and our teachers? And because my generation, us 90s babies, we're getting old. We can't do everything. Our time is almost up. Well, not our time, but we're older now, so we understand some of what our parents were trying to tell us when we were younger. So now it's like, okay, that is not what I'm talking about. Society has made it seem like you have to be, not society, social media has made it seem like, oh, I need to be 19 and in love. I need to be 18 and in love. Love will come. Love will come, but love will only come if you love yourself. Sorry, y'all. Hold on. Let me blend out my concealer. I can't talk and blend at the same time. Love will come when you're ready for love. And social media has made it where, like, everybody, let me not say social media, people have made it where men don't, I'm a traditional type of girl, so I'm used to guys coming up to me, introducing themselves to me. I'm not the type of girl that's gonna go out and say, hey, I'm not the girl that's gonna be like, hey, I like you. Here's my number. That's not me. That has never been me, nor will it ever be me. So, I've accepted the fact that I am 22. I am not 22. I am 23. And I am single. I am okay with the fact that I may be by myself for a long time. I am okay with that. I've accepted it. Being by myself is actually fun. I know some of you are like, being by yourself is fun. Look, y'all, I'm not the nicest person. I can tell y'all that I'm not the nicest person. I'm very mean. So when it comes to people's feelings and how I am with my words, I am like, okay, this is how I feel about what you said, and take it or leave it. I'm very, okay, my way or the highway type of person. And I know I can't be that way in a relationship, so until I'm willing to change, I'm going to be single. And I am okay with that. Yeah, I want to get married. Yeah, I want to have kids. Possibly. We have to pray about this kids part. Because, Lord Jesus, working in the daycare, that got me away from kids for a little while. But, yes, I'm okay with being single. And, yes, I'm okay with not keeping up with the Joneses. Yes, I'm okay with spending time with me and being by myself and loving myself. And I have my moments where I'm talking to my mom, I'm like, mommy, I want a boyfriend. But then I remember that I don't have to deal with nobody's emotions. nobody's ego, nobody's feelings, nobody's pride. And I'm only 22, and I prefer, if I was to date somebody now, I would prefer them not to have kids. And a lot of people are gonna say that's selfish, but I'm only 23. I have the right to be selfish like that. And if you feel that that's selfish, I'm sorry. But I'm not sorry. So, I'm single until God sends me the man that he wants me to be with. And yes, I made a list. Like, some of you know, they tell you to make a list and pray for it. Pray for everything you want. Be specific. Yes, I made my list, but I have not prayed for him because I'm not ready for him. And until I am ready for him, I'm not going to pray for him. Because I'm not that Proverbs 31 woman that I want to be. And I know this is the first time y'all have heard me talk about God on my channel a lot, but God has been working with me and dealing with me all of 2018. He's been talking to me, speaking to me, and I'm thankful for it. I'm thankful that my mama put me in a church where I learned how to talk to God and to be with God and to not fall susceptible to society's thoughts and stuff. Because, yeah, you know, you have those woke people that say this is the white man's religion. It was forced upon us and yada, 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 and all of that other stuff. But like I have this conversation with my mama all the time. I'd rather be this right than that wrong. Meaning I'd rather believe in God and everything that he says he is and who he is and the power that he possesses than to be wrong and end up in hell. I have this conversation with my mommy all the time. And that's another thing, like, y'all, I have the world's greatest mother. I can talk to my mama about anything. When I say anything, I literally mean anything. Like, me and my mama can have a conversation about drugs, sex, money, weed, God, the world, politics, like, I trust my mama with my, like, I know my mama's not gonna steer me wrong. My mama has my best interest at heart. We may bump heads, we may disagree, but I know at the end of the day, she's not gonna tell me something that's not good for myself. I know she's not gonna do that. This chit-chat get ready with me is all over the place. Oh yeah, a list of products will be down below because my face routine has not changed in a while. But I'm going to take the BH Cosmetics It's My Rare Rare Palette, and I'm going to take Brownie Bite to contour my face. And I probably need to get another one of these palettes because, y'all, I only use this shade in this palette. I haven't even touched the eyeshadows. Like, they look brand spanking new. I haven't even touched the eyeshadows. I only use it for this contour because this is the only contour that is dark enough for my skin tone. I thank you, Ray Ray. Appreciate you, girl, for looking at us, for us Melanie sisters. So let me give y'all a little backstory. I have been in 2 serious relationships my whole life. One of them was the love of my life. He was my everything. He was my first love, my first everything. And I love that man like no other. But he was not right for me. And I can say that now. And then my second serious relationship, taught me everything that I needed to know that I know today now to be in a relationship. It taught me how to talk to somebody, how to communicate with somebody without getting upset, how to talk to somebody without, how to communicate and communicate to listen and to understand what they're saying, and to communicate and to listen, to understand and to sympathize, because I wasn't sympathetic. So now I'm a little bit more sympathetic to people's feelings and emotions. So yeah, I lost my train of thought. I completely forgot what I was talking about. Oh, my second serious relationship taught me a lot of things that I didn't want in a relationship. It taught me that, it taught me a lot about myself and what I can and cannot tolerate and what I can and cannot handle. And I have not been in a relationship since. My first love and I are okay. We don't talk, but we're okay. My second love, we're not gonna speak on him, but I guess he's okay. So yeah, relationships are out of the question for me for a little while because I just don't feel like I need one. It's not in the cards right now. Yeah, I want one. Yeah, I have a crush, but at this point in my life, I'm like, no, I really don't see the need for one because I'm chasing my dream. And if you come alongside that and try to mess that up, we're going to have a problem. So, until God himself sends me a sign and says, Wesley, this is your husband. This is the man that I customly made for you from the womb. He's for you. He's about you. He's going to do you no harm. He's going to love you like no other. He's going to understand you. He's going to get you. He's going to come alongside you and help you realize your dream and help you realize who you are. And help you fulfill your destiny in my name. I am single. Okay? Alrighty. Moving right along. I talked about my life. I talked about dating. What else? Let's talk about toxic people, because I see a lot of that on social media. Letting toxic family members go, letting toxic friends go. But how do you determine who's toxic? For me, letting go of toxic people came through prayer. Like saying, hey God, if this person is not for me, show me so I can let them go. But in doing that, you also have to flip that mirror around and look at yourself and say, am I toxic to them? Am I hurting them? And I am any shape of way bringing negativity, toxic energy into their life? And if so, how am I doing that so I can fix it so I'm not the bad guy in the situation? And so, because a lot of people always say, oh, I'm getting rid of toxic people in my life and my life will be better. Not necessarily if you're the toxicity in the relationship. in the friendship, in the family ship. Like, if you're the toxic person, you're not gonna know you're the toxic person, or you're not gonna listen to somebody telling you that you're toxic because you think it's somebody else. So flip that mirror around and always look at yourself and say, give yourself a reality check, give yourself a self check. Hey, I need to get my together, basically, is what I'm saying. Do get your together. Be careful who you label as toxic, because they could be labeling you as toxic in their lives as well. Because I had a friend for a long time. I wouldn't say she was toxic, but the way she was handling her life and the way she was moving in her life, I knew that our friendship was going to come to an end, because I can't go forward and be in the same energy or the same space as her because of how she handled certain situations and how she carried herself. And I knew that I would not be able to do what God has called me to do if I was still her friend. Don't get me wrong, I still love her. I'm still cheering for her. But we're no longer friends. I wish her the best. I wish my other friend the best. But no, there were not toxic people in my life. Sometimes people aren't toxic. You're just going to outgrow them. And it is okay to outgrow people. You're going to grow. And sometimes the people that you think are your friends and you think they're supposed to go with you through life, God is like, no, baby, I want you to leave them there so I can take you to the next level. Or maybe God is like, no, baby, I need you to leave her there so I can take you to the next level. It works both ways. Everybody has to grow in life. Everybody has to go somewhere in life. Everybody's talking about these glow-ups. I don't believe in the glow-up. Yeah, you get older and you start to fill out your features, but other than that, is God elevating you to the next phase in your life of where he wants you to be? That's what I see it as. I don't know what you see it as, but that's what Wesley sees it as. I'm running out of things to talk about. Oh, setting goals. Set goals for your life. Set goals. When you set goals, write your goals down. Make a vision board. Put it on your calendar. Just put it somewhere you know you're going to look at it. Put those goals somewhere you wake up every day. My goals are my screensaver on my phone. Because I know one day I'm going to get to where I want to be. And in order to remember that, I need to see my goals. I have a vision. I hit pan in the middle. And I don't even use this highlighter that much. Sorry, y'all, got sidetracked. I have my goals on the vision board. Because one day, Wesley will be her own boss. Because one day, Wesley will have all of those things on her vision board. In time, I will have everything on that vision board. But it's going to take patience and prayer and understanding and fasting and making sure what I want lines up with what God has planned for my life. This video is going to be so long. But that's all right, because I feel like everything I said, you needed to hear. I feel like God is actually speaking through me to you, for those of you who believe in God. And if you don't, I'm sorry, you can go ahead and click out of my videos, because from here on out, I will be doing a lot more. I'm not going to say a lot more, but I'm going to be incorporating God in my content, because if it was not for Him, I would not be who I am, have what I have, or have the ability to do what I do. And I thank God each and every day of my life for giving me this ability. And I feel like I'm finally, like, in my calling. Like, this is what He wanted me to start a YouTube channel for. To encourage, ooh, that is a cricket lying down. To encourage young girls to be who they are. Believe in God. Trust in God. Love God. Don't let nobody's opinion about the white man's religion. About the white man's religion, cloud your judgment. If you believe in God, believe in God. Don't let nobody stop you from believing in what you believe in. Can't nobody stop you from believing in what you want to believe in? No way. If you believe God is God, there is no way somebody should be able to come in and tell you differently. If you have a strong foundation in the Word of God, nobody should come in and be able to tell you, oh, this is the white man's religion. This religion was forced upon y'all in slavery, and y'all still enslaved. Y'all still enslaved in the mind because y'all believe in God. Nope, not Wesley. I'm not enslaved. I'm just as free as I want to be. You cannot tell me that there is not a higher power in this world. All those conspiracy theories and stuff. Nope. And if you believe in God, you can't believe in, well, I'm not saying that you can't, but the Bible says you can only serve one master. You cannot serve two. So either you're going to believe in God wholeheartedly, or you're going to straddle the fence. And you know how He feels about lukewarm Christians. He's going to spit you out. Or you're going to get to that judgment day, and He's going to say, depart from me. I never knew you. And I don't want to be in either one of those positions. So from this day forward, my channel will be, I'm not going to say that. My channel, I will give more advice. I will say, I'm not going to say advice. How do I want to say this? I don't know. I just know I'm going to start. My channel's going to be different. So, from here on out, my channel's gonna be a little different. I'm probably gonna do more chit-chat, get ready with me, because it's just like talking. And I like to talk. I think I'm also gonna start doing like Foundation Fridays and stuff like that. Because there's a lot of foundations that just came out. Like, I know my foundation routine is kind of the same, but I can switch it up. All right, you guys, this is the end of my chit chat life update, get ready with me. I really hope you liked it.
Check the description box for all products below. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. Please subscribe to this channel, because I feel this channel is about to do some mighty work, y'all. Like, y'all just don't understand. Like, I've been refreshed, renewed, and rejuvenated. I'm here, I'm back. I know I say this every time, but every time before was different. I was still going through my little phases that I tell y'all about in the video. So just, like, please subscribe, comment down below so we can go on this walk together. Here's my hand. I'm holding out my hand to you. Come on this journey with me. Come take this walk with me, and let's see how far we can go.